The mainstream media has come out and they are officially trying to deceive people away from the significance of the coming blood moon. I saw this video on Hacking the Headlines channel yesterday. I watched the video yesterday. And it's unbelievable what this guy has to say in this video. This article is on Express, and it says, the Super Blood Wolf Moon Eclipse 2019. What does the Bible say about the full moon, or the lunar eclipse? Yeah, let's watch this video from this guy who is a pastor. He is a minister at a church. Let's see what he has to say here.
But what about that? Are there signs of the times? Is there a way for us to know that the end is near? Friends, the answer to this question is no. God has not given us indicators. He has not given us any signs to tell us the end is near. In fact, I want you to listen to Matthew 24 and verse 36. God is very clear about this. He says, but of that day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. Now that's interesting. The Bible says that the angels do not even know when the day of judgment will be. Mark chapter 13 and verse 32 mentions the fact that Christ himself did not know when the end would be, at least during the time that he was in his fleshly existence on this earth. Now, that's interesting to me that the Lord says the angels do not know. Christ himself did not know the day of his return. And yet we have people on this earth who think that they can figure it out.
Absolutely unbelievable to think that that guy is a pastor and a minister and an elder in a church. He works at the South Haven Church of Christ, and this dude is a minister. Okay, that's the most. This is what happens when people don't read their Bible. If you don't read your Bible, you don't know what it says, and then you're listening to these teachers who are either purposely deceiving or they're biblically illiterate themselves. So let's go to Matthew 24, one of the verses, one of the book or chapters that covers the tribulation and end times. It's extremely important for that. So let's see, he even mentioned that in verse 36 it says, but of that day and hour knoweth no man. No, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only, which is obviously true. No one knows the day or the hour. But let's go up just a few more verses to verse 32 and verse 33. It says, now learn this parable from the fig tree. When its branches has already become tender and put forth leaves, you know that summer is near. So you also, when you see all these things, know that it is near, at the doors. So Jesus even says, when you see these things starting to take place, you know that I am coming. But, of course, no one knows the day or the hour. If anyone were to say it's going to happen on, oh, let's say September 23rd, like all these false teachers like to say, then you know that they're lying because no one knows the day or the hour. But Jesus specifically said, when you see these signs that I just told you about in the previous verses, then you know that the end is near. Or how about we look in Luke chapter 21. In verse 25 it says, and there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and the earth, and on the earth distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. So God clearly shows us signs of the things that are coming. And later on in verse 28, he says, now when these things begin to happen, look up and lift up your heads, because your redemption draws near. And down in verse 31, just Luke's saying of the same verse of the fig tree, so you also, when you see these things happen, know that the kingdom of God is near. So clearly there is signs that we can look for and that we can see coming on the earth that Jesus told us about, that when we see these things happening, we know that it's getting closer. I mean, if people are getting the mark of the beast, that's a clear sign that things are getting closer to Jesus returning. Or when we see, like in Matthew 24, wars and rumors of wars and all of these things taking place, then yes, we know that the end is drawing near. Lift up your heads. Learn the parable of the fig tree. It's unbelievable that this guy, Don Blackwell, is actually a minister and says that Jesus did not tell us the signs of the times that are coming. And then he has the audacity or the complete stupidity to actually read out of Matthew 24, the book that mentions every single thing of the signs of the times that are coming in the tribulation. I mean, it that's just how the world is these days. If you don't know your own information, if you're not reading the Bible especially, and you're just taking man's words who loves to corrupt it, if you're taking their words for it, you do not know the truth of what is coming. But if you read, then you will learn and you will know the truth. Now, is this blood moon a sign of, it's definitely not a sign of the rapture. And please, anybody who wants to comment and tell me the rapture is before the tribulation, you need to comment with Bible verses, because I don't take man's word for anything, and there's nothing biblically that shows me that the rapture is before the tribulation. There's not a single biblical sound teaching, like someone mentioned and like in the last video, and it's so true, that the rapture was created out of the Scofield Bible. No teaching of the rapture before the Scofield reference Bible. So come on, people, you need to just look up on your own. Stop taking people's words for it, because just like when you take someone's word for it, like we're going to get raptured before the tribulation, you're listening to someone like Don Blackwell, who doesn't even know his Bible, who references Matthew 24 and then says that there's no warnings of the times to come. Absolutely insane. So what does this sign mean? Acts 2:19-20, I will show wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. We know that the sun, moon, and stars are created for signs. That's what God does. But we need to be aware of what these signs actually truly mean. Clearly, every single blood moon is not a sign of the coming of Jesus Christ, because there's been many blood moons since Jesus was on earth. But God gives signs and warnings in the sky and in the stars. The fact that this blood moon will be clearly visible over Washington, D.C. with the government shutdown, I think, is a crucial thing to pay attention to. An article that just came out that's very interesting, I think, that needs to be paid attention to, is by The Atlantic. They came out with an article saying, "Waiting for a shutdown to end in disaster." The person writing this article gave interviews to people in D.C., and this is what the interviews that were done off record, the people had to say. Here's the quote. "In these interviews, I heard an array of macabre hypotheticals, from airplane crashes to food safety scares, TSA strikes to terrorist incidents. But the one theme that ran through every conversation was a sense that the current political dynamics won't change until voters get a lot angrier." So here, I mean, you can take that in for exactly what it is. They want some disaster to happen, just like, I can't think of the guy's name right now, but he said, never let a good disaster go to waste. That's how our government works. And as we know, sometimes they even like to create these disasters. So yeah, that's something to pay attention to. Maybe it's a warning. Maybe this is a warning to the people in DC planning the next disaster to not do it. Hopefully they do not do that. But just the fact that this blood moon is over DC while we're dealing with the shutdown, and their talks of, well, disaster could fix the whole situation, just like it, oh, they always love, you know, don't let a good disaster go to waste. That's how these people operate. And from the sounds of it, wanting the voters to get a lot angrier and like uprise and riot in the streets, well, of course, we know what happens then. They come in with strict regulations, martial law. People are brought, the government and the military is brought in to control the situation. Just like after 9/11, we get the Patriot Act and we get TSA, which even years after years now, it's gotten worse than it was after 9/11. I mean, that's just how, that's how these things take place. When there's a disaster, they can move forward with their more tyrannical ways of living. They wish we all lived under a complete tyrannical system now, but we don't. So they want these disasters so they can get there. And this blood moon could be a warning of that. It's good to pay attention to everything going on surrounding an incident when something takes place, such as the blood moon. This is a prophetic warning because of everything surrounding it and where the blood moon will be seen. Washington, D.C., even the other day, felt an earthquake. As we know, God as well uses those as warnings too. So this is definitely a prophetic warning, and people should not listen to teachers who do not know what they're talking about. That the fact that that guy said that God does not give us warnings, unbelievable. I would not even be a waste of time to watch anything. He's got the documentary on Amazon. the kingdom in the end times or something. What a waste. What a waste of money that would be if you don't even know that God gives us specific warnings. Learn the parable of the fig tree, Don Blackwell. I can't believe that. That really irritates me. But just as the times that we are living in, it's a good time to, of course, get right with God, as every single moment is. Accept Jesus Christ, follow him. Take up your cross and follow him daily. And we will just do that as we move forward into the tribulation, where those who last until the end will be saved. The days will be shortened for the elect. Any false teacher who tells you these signs are a sign of the rapture, well, I can guarantee you it's a Don Blackwell type who doesn't know what the Bible says. Thanks for watching. God bless.